Hello, this is Rosie, the Pink Tank Engine, and I'm going to tell you the story of Peter and the Wolf. Now, when I hear this tale told to me, the speaker would explain how each person or animal in the story is described by a certain instrument in the orchestra. But I'm certain you all know that already, don't you? Well, okay, let's see if that's true. For instance, who's being represented by these three French horns? That's right, the wolf. And what is the oboe describing? Right again, the duck. And how about the flute? Bad in a thousand. The bird is the correct answer. Now, who's this loud character in the clarinet? Right, the cat. Then, of course, there's these well-known drum beats. Bust my buffers, that's right. It's the hunters shooting their guns. And who's this lumbering old bassoon? Grandfather. My goodness, you really know this piece, don't you? Well, I suppose it's all of them. Oh, wait! I almost left out the most important one of all. Can you guess who this string quartet is supposed to be? You got it right. That is Peter himself. I congratulate you on a perfect quiz. And now, the story can begin. Ahem! One morning, a young boy named Peter opened his gate and walked out into the big green meadow that was beyond it. Of a big tree in the meadow sat a little bird that was Peter's friend. "All is quiet," the bird chirped. Thank you. came waddling around. She was glad that Peter had not closed the gate, and seeing that it was open, decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. The little bird saw the duck and flew down upon the grass. The bird settled next to her and shrugged his shoulders. "What kind of bird are you if you can't fly?" said the bird. The duck replied, "What kind of bird are you if you can't swim?" and dove into the pond. The bird and the duck kept arguing, and the duck swam around the pond while the little bird hopped along the edge of the pond. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. He looked around and noticed a sly cat crawling through the grass. Cat thought, "That little bird is busy arguing with the duck. I'll just grab him while he is busy." Very carefully on her little velvet paws, she crept towards him. "Look out!" shouted Peter, and the little bird flew up into the tree for safety. While the duck quacked as loud as she could at the cat from the middle of the pond. The cat walked around the tree and thought, "Is it worth up so much energy and climbing up so high into the tree? By the time I get there, the bird would have flown away." Just then, Peter's grandfather came out of their house. He was upset because Peter had gone in the meadow without his permission. "The meadow is a dangerous place. If a wolf should come out of the forest, then what would you do? You would be in great danger." But Peter paid no attention to his grandfather's words. Boys like him are not afraid of wolves. took Peter by the hand, locked the gate, and led him home. No sooner had Peter gone back into his house than a big gray wolf came out of the forest. In a second, the cat climbed up the tree. The duck quacked and leapt out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she just couldn't outrun the wolf. He was getting closer and closer and catching up with her. Then he grabbed her with his teeth and with one gulp swallowed her. And now this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The bird on another. Not too close to the cat. And the wolf walked around and around the tree, looking at the cat and the bird with very hungry eyes. meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate and watched everything that was happening. He ran home, got a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall that divided his yard from the meadow. One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out way beyond the stone wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter carefully and quietly climbed onto the tree. Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle over the wolf's head. Try to distract him, but be careful that he doesn't catch you." The bird flew around the wolf and almost touched the wolf's head with his wings, while the wolf snapped angrily at him with his jaws from this side and that. How the bird annoyed the wolf, how he wanted to catch him. But the bird was clever and very quick, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso with the rope and carefully let it down from the tree. Catching the wolf by the tail. Peter pulled on the rope with all his might. Feeling himself caught by the rope, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. Peter tied the other end of the rope to the strong tree. And the wolf's jumping only made the rope around his tail tighter. Just then, two hunters came out of the woods. Following the wolf's trail and shooting their guns as they went. sitting in the tree said, "Don't shoot! Birdie and I have caught the wolf. Now help us take him to the zoo." Came the triumphant procession. Peter was the head. After him came the two hunters leading the wolf. Winding up the procession were Grandfather and the cat. Grandfather shook his head discontentedly. "Well, what would have happened if Peter hadn't caught the wolf? What then?" Above them flew Birdie, chirping merrily. "My, what brave fellows we are, Peter and I! Look what we have caught, a giant wolf!" And perhaps if you listen very carefully, you will hear the duck quacking inside the wolf, because the wolf in his hurry to eat her had swallowed her alive.